one tragic day, the ogre's popularity suddenly faded away. Fairy tale spoofs were no longer a thing. Not even a third movie was enough to keep him afloat. The money did save his movie, but it wasn't enough to save the ogre and his friends. But as time passes, people still question, is this movie bad as everyone said it is?
Greetings! Huh? Where am I? How did I get here?
I've done it!
Rumpelstiltskin?
I not only escaped my cage prison, but I can finally get my revenge on Shrek!
Let me guess, you tricked someone into giving away the day they were born as part of one of your magic contracts, which somehow caused some sort of alternate timeline, which somehow messed up my reality and set you free.
Close, but no on the first part.
Well then, what is it?
Some weird baby in the business who wanted to release their movie sequel in the summer.
Really? All that for Boss Baby 2?
Never heard of it.
Okay, I get the escape part, but what about the revenge part?
That's where you come in.
Me?
I know you're doing Shrek Month, and you're just about to talk about the third movie. If I can't erase him from existence, I'll destroy his popularity.
Listen, you crafty craftsman, I haven't seen this movie in a long time, and I was just about to look over it, so I decide whether it's good, bad, or somewhere in the middle.
Oh, perhaps we can make ourselves a deal.
It's not happening.
Worth a shot. Have a nice day.
So, how about Shrek 3?
As the Shrek franchise received enough praise from both critics and audiences, DreamWorks made plans to make more sequels up to number 5. However, unlike the other two, this one did not earn a happily ever after. While the third movie made enough money at the box office in 2007, people were not impressed with it. What's worse is that was the year where fairy tale parody movies pretty much died. How bad is it? Well, Shrek the Third not only became the worst Shrek movie, but also one of the worst DreamWorks movie, a runner-up behind Shark Tale. But is there any value within this movie that's seriously overlooked, or did Shrek make the right choice handing over the throne to someone else?
Welcome to another episode of The Wonder Reviews. Let's see what sort of throne this movie claimed. This is Shrek the Third.
In this sequel, Shrek and his friends attend the king's funeral, who tells Shrek that he wants him to take over the throne. Shrek, of course, declines so he can go back to his swamp with Fiona in peace. Before the king died, he requested that he can bring Arthur, played by Justin Timberlake, to Far Far Away as the rightful ruler. While that's going on, Fiona gets pregnant and Shrek gets worried about becoming a father. But the kingdom gets under attack by Prince Charming and the fairy tale villains, and it's up to Shrek and his friends to set things right. As you can tell, it throws out a lot of ideas and concepts to make it, in any shape or form, a funny movie. But there's one issue with the plot. It's boring. The problem with the story and the humor is that the pacing is really off. Some jokes drag on what feels like 10 minutes, like the king's final breath or Fiona gives Shrek the news. Or rely on film cliches without making fun of those film cliches like Donkey and Puss switching bodies.
Princess!
Puss?
Lo siento, princesa, but I am Puss. Stuck here inside this hideous body.
And that's just it about the movie. It's about Shrek trying to find the new ruler far, far away and being prepared to have a family, making all of its trials and tribulations extremely predictable from beginning to end. The saddest part about this sequel, it could have worked. The idea of Shrek ruling a civilized kingdom would sound interesting and conquering his fear of having a family. Even the jokes can give me some chuckles despite there are only a few of them. However, none of those specific side plots don't connect to the plot at all. The movie tries to connect them where Shrek interacts with Artie on how to become a king, but they go through more cliches like the liar reveal / misunderstanding, and no build-up for Shrek that he's ready to become a king or a dad.
And that's another thing this movie forgot to do what made the other two films stand out. They make fun of fairy tale cliches. So basically, it's not much of a fairy tale parody movie when you think about it. Even with some recognizable characters, there's nothing new about them, nor have any twists on them whatsoever.
Well, it is nice to see Shrek and his friends back on another whirlwind adventure, but there's nothing new from them, even comedy-wise. Shrek's arc is that he doesn't want to be king of Far Far Away so he can go back to the swamp with Fiona, but he has to overcome his fear of raising a family. All I can say is, I don't think he was prepared to be in this movie's plot at all. Donkey and Puss are still the comic relief, but the jokes from them are not as funny or memorable as their predecessors. Even the Freaky Friday-style body swap sounds like a tiresome comedy scene. The rest of their fairy tale friends don't really contribute much to the plot, and the fairy tale villains that team up with Prince Charming, like Captain Hook, don't offer a lot other than becoming the villain's army, since they're trying to find their own happily ever after. When it comes to the new characters like Artie, he absolutely has no personality and is only there to be a plot device where he can take over the kingdom instead of Shrek. His character is that he's a loser at his castle high school, but later becomes an underdog hero. And Merlin is the kooky wizard where his magic can sometimes backfire. As for the villain in this sequel, Prince Charming, he is the most generic antagonist in the Shrek series. Since we already saw the role reversal where the fairy tale hero like a prince or a fairy godmother becomes a villain, there's nothing more to him besides he wants revenge. The only characters that feel like actual characters would be Fiona and the princesses. Although there's nothing much to Fiona but to remind everyone she's going to be a mom, the princesses like Snow White, Cinderella, Sleeping Beauty, and Rapunzel do stand out thanks to their personalities. Alongside Queen Lillian and Doris, the ugly stepsister, they go through a journey on helping Shrek and defeating Prince Charming by being action ladies. It's the only cliche that this movie did manage to twist things around. As for the animation in this movie, it's still visually pleasing with some over-the-top cartoony moments. The character designs are good, rather be the human characters or the fairy tale creatures, and some of the backgrounds of Far Far Away are nice, especially Prince Charming's play at the end of the movie. Even the character animation is well done when Fiona and the princesses fight against the villains in the climax. However, the major downside to the animation, it stays too safe and doesn't add anything new. The locations the characters have to go through don't really offer a lot no matter which area Far Far Away they're at, and Artie's high school Worcestershire is basically a rip-off of Hogwarts from Harry Potter with some bland designs. And aside from Merlin's magic, there's barely any other visual effects compared to the other Shrek movies. The worst part about the animation is regarding Shrek's nightmare scene, which seems bizarrely outplaced for this fairy tale spoof movie. We know it's about Shrek being afraid of having a family and trying to be a good dad, but there's no need to drag on this dream sequence on why he's so worried.
I'm not saying that the animation is bad in this one, it's pretty good for what it is. It just wasn't good enough. There is a way to make Shrek 3 a good movie by simply making Shrek a king with some new fairy tale characters, fantasy realms, and original jokes. But when you add in a new boring character and don't connect the dots very well about becoming a king or having a family, then it's likely going to sink as the boat from the beginning of the movie.
Shrek the Third is a complete step backward of what made the other two extravagant in the first place. Instead of poking fun at fairy tale cliches, it brought in a bunch of other cliches with no twist whatsoever. Instead of adding new development to the characters, old and new, they rely on their own joke with nothing funny or memorable. And instead of wonderful animation, it stays too safe with nothing new to it despite some new features. Unless you want to binge watch everything Shrek related, just skip this movie and go back to watching the first two films. It's not a movie where it's so bad it's good, it's just tiresome. If Shrek wasn't ready to become a king or a father, then this sequel wasn't ready to become a movie. I gotta give this film a D+ and send it to the flames of failure.
I'm Matt Harpatrick. Now if you'll excuse me, I only have one chapter left before I close this book.
Thanks for watching this video. If you enjoyed this, feel free to like, comment, and subscribe me for a new review and other project every week. I'll see you soon.